Hello everybody, it's Dove. So I'm out in the Suboverland and I've got a problem. The battery that was in here, it finally died. I don't know why it died, because it had actually, I had just started it and moved it the week before, and you know, it wasn't cold or anything, but that battery died, and so I got a new AC Delco battery. And my ex put it in there and hooked it up for me, and I started it and it was fine, but then it was acting funny in here. I don't know if you can hear that or not, but the fan is on and it's blowing air out here, and the display, I couldn't make it stop. I just could not make it stop. And so I was fiddling with it, and I turned it off, but it didn't go off. The display went off, but the blower motor kept blowing. And I'm like, oh no, something's wrong. And so my ex, he just barely had time to even help me put the battery in, and he was getting ready to go to work. And I was like, well, I don't know what to do. And so I turned it off and took the key out. And as you can tell, it's still going. Can you hear that? It's still going. It's still blowing. So obviously, something happened. And the ex said that this kind of happened on his Impala. He had a battery off for too long. And when he finally did put a battery back on, it screwed up his BCM. And it made it so his fan mower, the fan in the motor was either always on or always off. I can't remember, but it was something he could live with. You know, this is not something I can live with. I don't even have the keys in the ignition, and that fan is on high. And so I've got to get my meter out. I went through and did all the updates and learned how to use it. I've got it hooked up here, the other end down there, so I've got to hook that up into my thing down here. I don't know if you can see that or not, probably not. But the other end for this meter is down there. This is the one I bought to fix the airbag warning light, because it always says service airbags. And I guess I need to start this. I should probably start it, but I don't want this new battery to run down. This is probably gonna take a while, because it has to go through the VIN number, and then it's gotta do a diagnostic and everything, and I'm afraid that, I'm just gonna start it, because I don't wanna run that down. Oh, now I really kicked on the high. But I can't. Oh my god, it's running weird. That was kind of running weird for a minute. It's a new battery. Idling weird for a second, sounded like. I still need to get a new serpentine belt. But yeah, I've got to hook this up, and I bought this unit. It's the OBD Plus that will do the service airbags, because that stays on, obviously, because I took the passenger seat out, and so it's totally screwed up. And I've got to try to clear that code with this. That's why I bought it, but I haven't used it yet. So I had to figure out how to use it. So yeah, I'm going to do that next. And hopefully it doesn't take too long for it to recognize the VIN number and go through all the different things. It's got to find the control modules. And oh my god, hopefully I can figure out how to use this thing. So, alright, I'll get back to you with an update, but so far it's not looking good. I have no idea how much a BCM costs, body control module. There's TCMs and PCMs and BCMs. I'm like, oh my God, you're killing me here. All right, I'll talk to you in a bit. Okay, so that didn't take too awfully long. It did the auto VIN number and was actually pretty fast. Now it is doing a quick scan, which accordingly here, it's for the control module selection. So it's doing this quick scan and it was like 12:16. That's not what time it is, but that's what time the clock says. So hopefully, I don't know if it's done. Hopefully it doesn't take too long. I don't know. I think it thinks it's done, but I'm gonna have to go in and do another scan because that's just the initial thing that you do. I thought it would bring up the obvious problem that it's having right now, but it didn't. So I'll get back to you. I've got to go over here and go to the read codes so I can get more in-depth information. All right, see you in a bit. Okay, well, I thought this was a good little unit, but it's not bringing up any codes. I just went through and read codes, and this is all it gave me. And that's all it did. And now I can't even get out. Like, I can't maneuver. If I can get you in the screen here. I mean, there's nowhere for me to go. And so it's not bringing up codes when there's obviously at least two codes. The airbag code should show up, and the whatever's wrong, but nothing's showing up. And I can't even get out of here. When I push okay, it does nothing. And none of these are highlighted. There's nothing to do down there with the F buttons. When I go back, am I sure I want to exit? Yeah, I guess. But that's where I was. Read codes. Okay. Here it is, reading again. This is the third time I've done this. Pass, no fault. Bullshit. Oh, sorry, pardon my mouth. But there's obviously something wrong. Why isn't it picking up on those codes? This better not be a piece of crap. This was like, I don't know, way more than the regular OBD readers. And see, it stopped. And now nothing. Nothing. What does this help button do? It made a sound. Okay, I'm getting no help. Oh no! Oh, you know, you guys. Is this a good brand or no? I don't know. I've never even used one of these. But it is not bringing up the codes. There should be all sorts of stuff. At least two things. Maybe I'll have to go to this live data here. I guess I'll try that next. Alright. Hold on. Okay, either I got a lemon or this thing's a piece of crap. I am not happy. I cannot get this thing to find these codes for anything. Like, nothing. I went through, there's nothing to freeze frame. The ECU information, that was useless. The live data, that was useless. No codes are showing up, and there's obviously a problem. I have two major problems, and it's not showing up either one of them. And I cannot keep sitting here with my battery hooked up trying to figure this out because it's running the fans. The fans are still going. I cannot get them to shut off. Still going. That's still on for some reason. Maybe that because this is still plugged in? I don't know. I'm gonna unplug it now though. No. Maybe that's always on? I don't know. That shouldn't always be on. There's something wrong. No key. Fans still going. Can you hear them? So now I've got to go back out there and take off the ground wire of the battery because that's the only way to stop it is just to disconnect the ground on the battery. And this was of no help. $140 freaking paperweight as far as I'm concerned. I don't know what to do. I guess I can just pull the fuse for the fans. I mean, that'll work for a while. I've not used the air conditioning or the heat yet, but I'm not living in this thing yet. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna want to have the ability to turn the fan on. But for right now, I either leave the battery unplugged or I take that fuse out. And then, whatever. I guess I'm gonna have to take it in to have somebody look at it because I am not able to troubleshoot it. So I just lost my money there and now I've gotta go spend money on an actual mechanic. Yay. Oh boy. Okay. Well, I'll talk to you guys later.